Hello everyone and welcome to another Feed Army video. My name is Emanuel and today I want to talk about the product protection feature within Google Merchant Center. Last week I've noticed that there are a lot of emails being sent out that large numbers of products are removed from the feed. Now what I did not know, and I think this feature has existed for a couple of months or even longer, but I've never really noticed it, is that these products will stay within your account even though they're removed from your feed. Now that is really annoying, isn't it? You would assume, okay, products are removed from the website, they should be removed from the feeds. And that, well, that will happen, but not from your Google Merchant Center account. But that will happen as long as the percentage of your product protection is lower than what you've set. And I actually never really noticed it, because before, the product protection percentage was just basically, look, we're sending you an email, there's maybe something wrong with your feed where, let's say, more than 10% of your products has disappeared. But now it seems like if that threshold is reached, so if your percentage is 10% and you have, let's say, 15% products that have been removed, what Google will do now is they will stay within your account even if they are removed from your feed. That is really annoying. So here's an example that I have noticed. So I was a little bit puzzled. There was like lots of products where the availability in the feed said out of stock, but I couldn't really find where this product was coming from. First, I thought, okay, this is just an issue with structured data, or the feed is not updated. So I checked, yes, the feed is updated daily, as you can see here, the 30th of July, yesterday. And then I checked structured data, that is not no issue. The website landing page looks okay. And then I was trying to find why it says out of stock in the feed. And I couldn't find it in the feed itself. So I was like, how is that possible? So then I wanted to check, okay, but if it's updated on the 30th of July, maybe there are some errors within the feed. That can happen. For example, not with a TSV file, but like, let's say with an XML file, one character can completely destroy the whole feed. So nothing works, or at least after that specific character. But I have had a look here and I noticed this new message. I was like, what is this? I've never noticed this before. High number of missing items. The number of removed items in this feed exceeds the item deletion threshold. Any new or updated items were inserted according to the feed, but missing items were not removed from the account. Check the most recently uploaded file, and if the deletion was intentional, you can force the deletion by clicking remove items. I thought like, well, that is a little bit annoying. Why would I need to manually click on remove items if they're already removed from the feed? So I thought like, maybe this is related to the threshold. And I was never really aware that this was the case, because before, like I said, would just send you an email rather than perform any real actions. So when you go to general options, so it will be, it depends on where you're looking at. So in the new UI, it will be here in the left. But if you go to cogs item, then it will be general account options. And here you will see turn on product protection 5%. Now, the reason I was so confused is because this is a new client and 5% is quite a lot. So I would change that to maybe 30%, because that would, anything below 30%, I would assume that is like intentional. So that is, it doesn't make any sense that we would set it to 5%, because then you would always have those products still listed in account, and then you get lots of issues within the needs attention tab, and then you get just confused. So I'm just gonna save that for this client. There we go. So yeah, that is, if you notice that products have been removed from your website and you are sure that it's more than 24 hours ago, then most likely this is your issue. So go to, let's just go through the steps. So go to data sources. So if you have the new UI, it will be here, and then data sources. And then click on your primary feed, which one is causing the issue. and then go to latest update, and then here we will want to remove the products. And then obviously your issues will go away. So just to demonstrate, so we had needs attention, and this was the issue what I had, like mismatch value. I'm like, why is that? It makes no sense. At first thought, the client was using the Google and YouTube app, and this app was not updating, but clearly it is something else, and it is related to the product protection. So this part here. So how much the percentage you should choose, that is up to you, but just maybe consider, like, how many products do you delete intentionally once in a while in bulk? So if that is, like, let's say maybe just 10% that you know that you're deleting in bulk, then set it to maybe 50 or 20%. But honestly, because I manage my clients on a weekly basis, I check all the products all the time. So this threshold is not really necessary for me because I will pick it up quite easily. However, it's quite good if, for example, you need to check it daily, if you have large volumes of products that change constantly, then yes, this is quite good. If you don't want products to be removed, then disable this feature. So what you choose, that depends on your scenario, what you want. But I would recommend turning it on, because you never know that the data feed accidentally failed on a certain day. So then you can take action quite quickly, rather than, for example, for me, let's say a week. That is a week where the customer has no sales. That wouldn't be very good. So then just enable it with a percentage. So I hope this has been useful for you to find out why products are still in your account but already removed from the feed. So this is the reason. It's very new, and I believe it only started 2 weeks ago, but I'm not 100% sure, but I assume it is a new feature. So thank you for watching in this video. If you have any comments or questions, feel free to leave a comment downstairs, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.